Welcome to Connect What Matters, highlighting technology that enables transparency, compliance, and competitive advantage. Today's demonstration is hosted by Junction Solutions and highlights milk receiving and settlement.
One of the industry verticals that Junction Solutions specializes in is food and beverage. And as a result, we've created a number of extensions to Microsoft Dynamics AX to help those customers' specific needs. Today, we will look at one of those designed specifically to help the dairy customers receive and pay for the milk that they receive from their cooperatives or farmers through a quick and simple process. This should make their lives and also their accounting a lot less complicated. First, we're going to look at the milk receiving process. Junction Solutions have created a milk receiving workbench that allows us one single place to enter in all the information regarding the receipt. In order to create a new receipt, all we need to do is specify who we're going to receive the product from, which co-op or which farmer, and then we have a contract associated with that supplier. This contract could have different QC requirements, it could have different prices associated with it, and also could have separate effectivity dates. Now I'm going to specify the carrier and the load that this came in on. If we wanted to specify additional information about the carrier, then we can go to the carrier screen and we can enter in the serial number, we can enter in the driver information, we can enter in any information about the trailer. But I'm just going to select this. As soon as I've received the load or entered in the load, it's going to tell me that there's a quality order required for this shipment. This could have antibiotic requirements, or it could have cleaning requirements, or just general visible checks that we want to apply to this receipt. But for now, I'm just going to close this down. We'll get back to that later on. Now I'm going to tell the system, what am I receiving? I'm just receiving in some raw milk. And how much product am I receiving in? We'll receive in a full tanker. If the butterfat content is different from the standard, which is 3.5%, then we could update that. But for now, we'll just leave that how it is. And again, now that I've entered in the line, there's also a quality alert against the line. So this is completely optional, but it allows us to have different tests against the truck and also against the product itself. Now that we have the main information entered for the load, let's just enter in the QC results. In this case, I have 5 QC tests that need to be applied to this product. I can tell the system how much I'm going to test, and then enter in the results. In this case, I just need to specify the QC results, validate them, and as soon as I have all of this information entered in, I can approve this quality order. Any of these QC tests can have a pass or fail outcome. In this case, there are no traces of antibiotic, and I'm going to pass this. By posting these results, it then asks me who am I so that there can be a electronic signature associated with this transaction. I'm going to validate this, and now all inventory holds have been cleared against this quality order. Now, I still have the quality order against the header or against the load. In this case, I'm going to enter in the quality again and enter in the same information. Now when I validate this, it's going to remove the quality hold, and now the load is available to be put into inventory. In order to send this and update inventory, all I need to do is apply the receipt. It has gone out and created the inventory journal for me, and now the milk is available for me to further process. If I have other receipts here, then I can also post those as well and apply those and update the inventory. Now that we've received in the milk, we want to apply the prepayment. In this case, we can now go into the milk receipts invoicing and tell the system what invoices or what receipts do I want to apply. In this case, it's gone out and found all four of those receipts that I just updated and posted into the system. I can post all of these just by a simple update. The final step in the dairy process is the dairy settlement. For this, I can go into the dairy settlement screen. I can tell it what date do I want to settle against, and then also which vendor do I want to settle. And then I can generate all of the milk receipts for that supplier. Here you can see all of the product that I've received in, and also it's showing me what the settlement value should be. I can override this and enter in the actual settlement amount that we're receiving from the dairy or from the supplier or from the cooperative, and it's going to go out and create the adjustment journal for me and create the payment that's required for that supplier. So in three simple steps, we've gone out and received in the product, we've applied a prepayment at any time during the month, which we can have multiple prepayments per supplier per month. And then finally, I've created the final settlement, which allows us to settle out the account for that cooperative or for that farmer. All in all, I think this is a very simple process and makes the milk receiving and settlement cycle a lot easier for our customers.
Thank you for joining us for today's demonstration of milk receiving and settlement, one component of an end-to-end solution set for food and beverage built in Microsoft Dynamics AX. This series is hosted by software and services provider Junction Solutions, an award-winning Microsoft Gold partner and leader in the food and beverage industry. For additional details or to contact a member of our team, please visit us online at junctionsolutions.com.